Good evening, and welcome to the Farmingdale High School PlayCrafters production of Footloose. Please take a moment and silence your cell phones, as they are disturbing to the actors and interfere with our sound system. There will be a 15-minute intermission where refreshments will be sold. Food and drink are not permitted inside the auditorium. We dedicate tonight's performance to Gina Pelletieri and B. Ferrari, two inspiring community friends who are integral members of our music and art community. Their presence will always be felt in this auditorium. Now, everybody, cut loose, kick off your Sunday shoes, and enjoy Footloose.
Thank you. someday, Lord, I pray, tell me exactly the words to say. Give me strength, and maybe then I can reach my fellow men, so we all may rise again. Thank you, Lord, amen. Long way to church this morning. Down past the old creek, I heard birds chirping and our very own choir warming up in the distance. And I was reminded of a line from our great poet, Walt Whitman, who once wrote, "I hear America singing." And I thought, aren't we the song that we sing? Don't we all lift our voices to tell the world who we are and what we believe? So, I ask you all this morning, what song are you singing?
We've only been here 2 days and already Chicago seems a million miles away. We were barely hanging on there, especially with my father gone. There's not too many places we can stay, but maybe Mom can find a job that's steady, and maybe I can stand it for a year, and maybe things won't be so bad, and maybe I will miss my dad, and maybe we can start a new life here.
But if Walt Whitman were alive today, what song would he hear America singing? When I turn on the television, all I hear is the music of easy sexuality and relaxed morals. I hear rock and roll and the endless chants of pornography. And I ask myself, why does our Lord allow this? We know God has the power to turn all those records and books and videos into one big fiery cinder like that. But he doesn't. And why? Well, that is because God is testing us. He's watching to see whether we'll choose his path or not. And that is why every day we must all ask ourselves, have I done the right thing?
Have I done the right thing? Picking up my life, packing up the past. That's always the right thing. Have I done the right thing?
Just arrived from Chicago. Ethel McCormick and her son, Ron, is it?
Ren.
Huh? Speak up! Let the Lord hear your voice! Ren! Ren McCormick! Ren. Interesting name. Now, is that short for something? Nope.
There's rumors going around about the new kid.
To join my wife Vi and our daughter Ariel in this morning's convocation.
God is love. Follow him and never roam. He has made the stars above just to light your way.
Everybody!
The fact that we're truly celebrating, it's costumes are alive.
McCormick, your sister has certainly been very excited about your moving in with them.
Lulu and Wes have been my rock.
Oh, it's been no trouble. Apple just moved right into the guest room.
And Ren, where does your uncle have you staying?
Do you remember our old tool shop in the garage?
Wes, that place is a greasy dump.
Well, no more.
Picture this. Powder blue wallpaper, chocolate brown carpet.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
When will Mr. McCormick be joining us?
Mr. McCormick won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separated.
He ran off to go find himself.
Ren, please.
Bye! Bye! I made some of my famous Toll House cookies. Lulu, you try one and you'll burn every recipe in your kitchen. Won't you join us, Mrs. McCormick? Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Oh, call me Ethel, please.
Only if you call me Mai.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Ren, are you all set for school tomorrow?
We took care of that last week. Gochi helped them get registered.
Hey, Ren, did you hear the new English teacher's trying to introduce some vulgar modern novel to our American Lit course?
Slaughterhouse 5. Yes, Coach, I've received several calls.
Slaughterhouse 5? That's a cool book, cover to cover. Slaughterhouse 5, right? I mean, yeah, that's one rockin' story. It's a classic.
Do you read much?
Well, Coach, maybe in another town it's a classic.
In any town, Uncle Wes.
And Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Daddy? Excuse me. Rusty and Wendy Joe are going out for burgers tonight, can I?
Tomorrow's a school day.
Oh, Daddy.
Ask your mother.
We already did, Reverend Moore. She said it was okay with her. If it's okay with you, so it's okay with you.
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. Great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
And all what you said about well, women, rock and roll, listen to the music in your soul and all that. I mean, I was like, who knew?
High praise indeed. Gentlemen.
I, on the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up. Well, then, Ariel, why don't you just talk to him? Why? He doesn't listen to me in any way.
Welcome to Beaumont!
Howdy.
Ooh, you are cute. Wendy Jo is me cute. And I bet he knows he's cute. Don't you think, Wendy Jo? Come on, where are you going? Come on.
Hey, you two, put your tongues back in your mouths and let's get out of here.
See ya.
And where are you going? Where do you think? And if the question ever comes up, I was with you guys all evening. Right? Are you asking us to lie for you? Yeah.
Okay!
Hey, good looking. You miss me?
You wish.
Hey there, Ariel.
How's it going?
Hey, Travis. Lyle. Oh my god. Did I interrupt your weekly poetry club meeting?
Very funny. So, who's that new guy in church?
Who? Oh, him! He's our new classmate. A Chicago transplant with all the charm and sophistication that comes from living in a bustling metropolis.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Hey, Cranston, just what are you doing with the preacher's daughter?
Anything that I want.
Oh, yeah? What does she get out?
Everything that she needs.
Like you know.
Will she like you to think she was born yesterday with her innocent looks and in little town ways? When she's smiling at me, she's got angels in her eyes. But I've seen how she moves and this girl really cooks. She taught me some tricks you can't learn in books. And I'm starting to think she's a devil in disguise. The girl gets around.
I swear God's gonna strike you down with the lightning bolts.
No, she's not.
She's not.
Excellent.
Yeah, he likes to pretend he's a man among men. But with his hands in his pockets, he can't count to ten. Don't worry, baby, his secret's safe with me.
We were just on our way.
Your mother thought you might be cold.
Evening, Reverend! The girl gets around.
Out.
Grab a seat. Check it out.
You ain't gonna last about 5 minutes in this town.
Oh yeah? Watch me, kid.
Whoa, I thought it never would end. I lost it somehow. But you look at me now. Watch my P's and Q's. Maybe look before I leave. And then I say, hey, what's the use? Ain't done it yet. I can't forget how it feels when you dance and drop. You don't even start to suggest that I stop. I never will. I can't. Oh. I can't stand still. Oh, no, 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 no.
Mr. McCormick, Mr. McCormick, what do you think you're doing?
Well, I was just telling Willard about Chicago. You know, Chicago, that title in town.
That's not what it looked like.
Oh, well, you know, I threw in a few dance moves and...
No,
you know,
don't
this.
Mr. McCormick, there is no dancing allowed here.
What? Listen to the woman. Oh, I get it. School property, not supposed to have any fun.
That sort of remark may pass for wit in Chicago, but here we speak simply. Let me make this as clear as I can. There is absolutely no dancing of any kind, at any time, anywhere within the town limits of Beaumont.
Well, yeah, but of course...
Ever!
All right, she's joking, right? She can't be serious. Oh, I get it. Joke's on the new kid. Ha ha, so funny.
Mr. Hewitt, would you inform your friend?
It's against the law.
Dancing? Get out.
Shut up. Principal Clark, ma'am, Ren is very sorry. He was unaware of our local law, and I will inform him of his ignorance.
I will see both of you in my office after school. I'm sure we all have somewhere to be! Oh my gosh, Willard, the way you spoke to Principal Clark, I mean, wow, that's like the longest sentence you've ever made! Chin up, Mr. McCormick. It is such a turn on watching a guy fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Wendy Jo? Uh-huh.
Was she serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is against the law?
Has been 5.5 years, ever since the incident.
What incident?
Well, ladies, should I take this one? Please, be my guest. There were these 4 kids we all grew up with who tragically passed after a night out dancing.
Oh, God.
And when the sheriff's office published the autopsy report, they found alcohol in their blood. Everybody in the town went nuts. And that's when Reverend Moore got so righteous. He started blaming everything, anything. Drugs, liquor, rock and roll.
And dancing.
You got it. He convinced the town council it was all a sin, and just like that, he passed this law.
Wait. Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore? He is the power.
He is the law.
Wow. I mean, how could you guys stand to live like this?
Practice. Years of practice. It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to get to live in a city where you can just walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know.
Yeah, I miss that. I don't know, I thought that moving to a small town would be like joining one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move. There's fingers pointing every time you turn around.
There's heads shaking the minute you cross the line. And there's eyes everywhere. Careful what you do, someone's on to you. Careful what you do. Careful what you say, 'cause you're on display every night and every day. Somebody's hiding in the great unknown. And every time you think that you're alone,
but it's not gonna get me.
Gets to everybody.
You don't know me.
You don't know Beaumont.
Somebody, 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 somebody dies. Oh. Somebody, 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 somebody dies. Oh.
You're gonna have to learn that in Beaumont a stop sign means stop.
But officer, I thought I did.
And that radio music of yours is blasting pretty loud.
Oh, so you pulled me over because my music's too loud?
Hey, watch that attitude, boy.
Book him, Jim!
This a friend of yours, Chuck? The city kid?
They seem nice.
Careful how you speak. Turn the other cheek. Be careful how you speak. Think a naughty thought. And if you get caught, well then, boy, you've got of trouble. Somewhere there's someone with the perfect you. And they're just dying for a little peek-a-boo.
Boom!
Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes will never close, never sleep. Somebody's after the secrets that
Principal Clark, this boy turned my wrestling practice into a brawl.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and I suppose my nose is slammed into your fist?
It's Bullman. I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, that's enough! My boys know the difference between a wrestling practice and a street fight.
Oh, really, Coach? A wrestling match is usually one-on-one.
That is enough out of you! This is the third time in however many weeks you've been dragged into my office. You're suspended from the wrestling team.
What?
Indefinitely!
You know how hard it was for me to get you that job at Dillahan's hardware store? It's not even a month, and you get fired!
Every day it's more bad news with you. Every day!
Lulu, don't exaggerate.
It's a little hush. You're not helping things.
Ren, what did happen?
Nothing that I should be fired for. Willard came by the store and asked for a change of a dollar. So I opened the register, and when Mr. Dillahan saw my hand on the counter, he went crazy. He accused me of stealing.
That's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you stealing?
No! But why don't you frisk me, Uncle Wes? I'm sure you've already gone through everything in my room.
Ren, apologize to your uncle.
Look, young man, I know that I'm not your father.
Hey, you can say that again.
Wes!
Don't say anything, Ethel!
I cannot say anything. I don't know how to do that, Wes.
Pumpkin, hush, please.
Wes, I realize that we're guests in your home.
Ethel! Right now, just don't say anything.
Never laugh too loud, never leave a crowd, never dress risque, they'll be held to pay. If you've ever had anything to hide, think twice before you step outside.
Step outside. Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are following every move. Somebody's waiting to show they don't.
don't want to be late.
What's a few more minutes?
My dad is still not crazy about my seeing you.
Well, tell him to get used to it.
You tell him.
All right, I will. Reverend Moore!
Maybe not right now. I'm not in the mood for one of his sermons. Bye now. Go! Go home!
Doesn't confuse the mind.
Are you working on your sermon?
I am.
Remember when I was a kid, on Saturdays, I'd sit in a pew down front and listen to you practice over and over.
I do indeed.
And then I would clap and you would bow, I remember.
Well, it seems you've outgrown that now.
Shaw.
What just happened? Did I say something wrong?
Your father's had a difficult day.
I can speak for myself, Vi.
Honey, why don't you go finish setting up the table?
I'm not really hungry.
Shaw, if you're angry with Ariel, please tell her why.
I'm not angry. I'm just, concerned.
You can get to the point. You two speak and nothing gets said.
Well, have you seen her off with this Chuck Cranston? All right, the last time I walked in on the two
you
of them...
You told me.
The boy has records of arrests, Vi.
And the more you object, the more intrigued she's going to be.
So I should hold my peace?
I do. And I pray that her infatuation with Chuck Cranston lasts no longer than mine with Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell was not an overheated delinquent.
Oh, he most certainly was.
This is not funny.
I'm just trying to lighten the mood.
Well, I can't. I'm frightened about where Ariel is and what she is doing.
You can't expect her to sit home with us.
Let's stop this conversation right here, Vi.
Conversation?
Vi!
I seem to have walked in on one of your sermons.
Please, let us not say anything we may regret.
Swallowing my words. Staring at the floor, counting little cracks in the tile, struggling to smile without choking, learning to be silent.
Watching how the dust dances at the door, noticing my hands start to shake, contemplating taking up smoking, learning to be silent. Always hearing, hush, Ethel.
Please, bye.
Let's not have this conversation. And so I stand by while my mind takes a small vacation. La la la, la la la, la la.
Other folks ignore.
gone.
Some we avoid like the plague. I'm becoming a mime, biting my tongue, biting my tongue, trying not to scream. Knowing if I'm going to survive, then damn it! I've got to practice
my nation.
Willard, shut up and tell me, what do you know about Ariel?
Well, I know she's been kissed a lot. And she's auntie like a hog on slop.
Get out of here.
Ariel likes trouble, and you have definitely proved to everybody in this town that you are T-R-U-B-L.
Come on. I was only teasing him. That was my
more than teasing. Wren is from out of town, and don't tell me that doesn't curl your toes.
You want out of Beaumont so bad, I bet you memorized bus schedules.
You said you read just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly. In books, I get to meet guys who amaze me.
And what about Wren?
What about him? He's sort of smart.
He's kind of tall.
Everybody's tall on roller skates.
And I think he's handsome.
Cute, maybe.
But can he compare to Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout / drug dealer who was recently evicted from a trailer park? I don't think so.
So, Willard, what's the deal with you and Rusty?
Beats me. I think she's good looking and all, but I never know what the hell she's talking about. She talks faster than any guy I've ever met.
That's because she likes you.
You think?
If only I could find a guy who could make the first move.
If only I could find a guy who, when he went to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth. If only I could find the guy.
Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods?
Yeah.
Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising odds?
I'd like to know.
Isn't there a white knight upon a fiery steed? Late at night I toss and I turn.
And he's gotta be
Chuck is gonna lose it.
Ariel, what the hell is going on? We had a date a half an hour ago.
Chuck, I'm sorry.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
And why would you? You do such a good job of it yourself.
Shut up, Rusty. Will you be joining the ladies for dinner? When I say meet me at 8, what am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right. Just calm down.
Don't tell me to calm down. Don't ever tell me what to do. I know what your friends think of me. And that's bull. I'm the best party in this town, baby, and those three dogs ought to be tied up under the porch. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no, Chuck. Leave me alone.
Come on. I believe the lady said no. And I believe this is none of your business.
Ren, don't.
Ariel, who invited this clown?
Oh, I'm sorry. We've never been formally introduced. Ren McCormick, and you are?
Get your hand out of my face and get your face out of my sight.
Chuck, you want to fight? Well, let's party.
Hey, Willard, don't lose me this job.
Oh, man, let me nail it. Ow, damn!
No, stop. What are you doing?
Hey, we got a problem here?
No, ma'am. We were just discussing the comfort and safety of one of our valued customers.
What? You think that's funny?
Branson, this here is my establishment, and your pickup truck is parked on my sidewalk. Now, you got about 30 seconds till it's towed. You know what I'm saying?
You haven't seen the last of me, McCormick.
Could I will
please... What's that your mom says? Oh! Before you make a fist, make sure it's your fight.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, this is not your fight. Don't the rest of you have a curfew? And McCormick.
I know. I'll turn to my skates.
Listen to me. I'll see you here after school tomorrow.
Wait, really? So I'm not fired?
Not yet. Now give me a push, honey! Thank you. You are either very brave or very stupid.
Which do you think?
I haven't made up my mind. Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Ooh, you're right. Please, my daddy invented it. But don't you think rules are made to be broken? Come on.
Red cowboy boots.
My daddy hates me wearing these boots.
And you love that, don't you? Just getting all up in his face.
That way he'll notice when I'm gone.
Well, where are you gonna go?
College, for starters. I've applied to some places my daddy doesn't even know about. I want to speak 5 languages and see the world. He wants me to teach English lit in Baylor County. They don't even speak English in Baylor County.
Well, I can never see you as a teacher.
Thank you. Neither can I. I'll leave that to my daddy.
He's a preacher, not a teacher.
Well, when you're good at it, it's the same thing. And he used to be real good.
Well, what changed?
His mind. He closed it.
I noticed.
He used to be so open, so inspiring. I've seen him give people hope when hope was gone. I've watched him change lives.
If you love him so much, then why do you always just want to tick him off?
I didn't say I love him.
Boy, do I know what you mean. My dad...
Yeah. What happened there?
He left. One day, he just walked out the door and left. No goodbye, nothing.
Woo! I bet you got lots to say to him.
Lots.
Like what?
Oh no, I couldn't really.
Tell it to the train. I do.
Ah! How could you be so stupid to leave Mom and me? I hate you!
Feel better?
I'm not sure.
Do you wanna kiss me?
Someday.
Someday? What do you mean, someday?
I mean that I've got a feeling that you've been kissed a lot. I'm worried I'd suffer in comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you?
I think more of you than I ever thought I would. Oh, come on, I'll walk you home.
Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are following every move. Somebody's waiting to show they don't approve.
Let's see. Herod, you owe Eleanor
75 cents. And Reverend, you owe me a buck and a quarter.
Oh, Eleanor, why does it seem that the only place my prayers seem to fail me is at the bridge table?
Come on, just say hello to everybody. Hi, you all know Reverend McCormick. Daddy, Reverend.
Reverend Moore, how's it going?
Oh, Principal Clark, Coach Dunbar.
Hi, Mrs. Dunbar.
Mrs. Moore?
Welcome, Rem.
Whoa, poker night. Cool.
Ariel, all this time we thought you were upstairs, in your room.
Doing your homework.
You know, it's hard to impose a curfew on the young people of my congregation, but I can't seem to enforce one in my own home. Well, what's the old saying, Reverend? It's the shoemaker's children who always go barefoot.
Oh, would you look at the time?
Yep. I'll walk you guys out.
Bye, Mrs.
Yeah.
Oh, I think I left my oven on. See you tomorrow. I have to feed my cat. Sorry.
Okay. Well, I could sure empty your room. It's a rare talent. I'm going to take that as a compliment.
Oh.
Well, I can assure you that it was not meant that way.
I believe this is yours.
Friend! Thank you for, you know.
Walking you home?
Yeah, that too.
Well, Reverend, this was fun, don't you think?
Somebody's eyes are seeing you come and go.
Boy, I sure blew it in there, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
I get so nervous, you know, when I go crazy. And I end up putting my foot in my mouth.
Your mother said you were good at it, but I had no idea.
Well, then
Good night, Mrs. Moore. Good night, Ray.
Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes.
Whoa! I'm gonna punch out somebody, 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 somebody's eyes.
Whoa!
I don't want you to see him again.
Ren? Why? Just because he hasn't lived in this town his whole life?
That's not it, but clearly the boy has no respect for authority. And everybody tells me that he is a troublemaker.
Who's everybody? The Bridge Club? Give me a break.
Ariel, what am I going to do with you?
Me? Daddy, lately all you do is look for the worst in people. And then, of course, you find
my, it. My, where did that come from?
From you! Daddy, today's sermon is, the world is evil, and Ariel has to be locked away in a tower.
Well, that's a little melodramatic, don't you think?
No, I don't. Daddy, you make me feel like a prisoner, and I hate it. I just hate it.
Well, somebody's got to put a foot down.
I didn't say anything.
I don't enjoy being her giver. I don't relish telling her no. But then I think, what if I fail her? How can I just let her go? I strive to be a good preacher. I try not to go overboard. But then I think, if I can't reach her, how can I face my Lord? Heaven help me shoulder my load. Every day's a struggle still. Someone's got to take the high road. If I don't, who will? I became a man of God to do his work, to spread his word, to ease some pain and dry some tears. That was the plan. But I might have thought twice if only I knew that I'd spend all of my time saying, no, no, don't do that. See, everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is, here's my frustration. Nobody wants to have a rule. So heaven help me with my labors. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors? Heaven help me. Oh, heaven help me. If heaven can't, who can?
Anybody you know?
Well, I wasn't taking names, if that was what you're suggesting.
McCormick, it seems that when you're not causing the trouble, it tends to find you anyways. Ariel, I suggest you stay away from this guy. I've been asked to keep a close eye on
you. My dad called you? Surprise, surprise.
And if you cooperate, it'll make our lives much easier.
Gee, if my daddy makes a phone call, will you get off on my back?
That mouth of yours probably made your daddy walk out in the first place.
Hey, count to ten, man. Mama says, Just count to 10.
You'd be wise to take your friend's advice. Ariel, get back to practice. And McCormick, drop and give me 30.
You're joking.
You're right. Make it 50.
He's not faking, Coach. He's really hurt.
Thank you for your diagnosis, Dr. Willard. You can give me 50 as well. As a matter of fact, you all can give me 50. Courtesy of Mr. McCormick. Just do it! And one, two, I can't hear you! Three, four, only 46 more!
Five, six.
Is he gone?
Seven, eight.
Yup. Hey, Brent, thanks a lot.
I'm sorry, guys. It's just, this whole damn town is so wound up.
Hey, man, you guys have no place to blow off any steam.
You could say that again.
I mean, at least in Beaumont, we had the clubs. Not Beaumont, Chicago. Sounds warm my mind.
Maybe we ought to take the coats dancing.
Willard, you are so...
What?
That's it.
Wait, what? What are you thinking?
We're gonna throw a dance. We're gonna throw a rockin' party that's gonna blow Beaumont right up its tractor. Bring it on.
Are you ready to take on Reverend Moore?
I'll take on anybody.
What about the town council?
I'll fight City Hall. If there's one thing that's worth fighting for, it's freedom.
Looking into your eyes, I know I'm right. If there's anything worth the fear, it's worth the fight. Can tie my hands or make me change my plans. I'm crossing the line. The track, taking what's mine and not looking back. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. We can face it out right now, right here. Once you're standing on your own two feet, you will not retreat.
You're not free. You're crazy. You know there's a law.
And maybe it's time that law needs changing.
Hello, Beaumont is not going to let us forget what happened 5.5 years ago.
How long have you been living in that shadow? I mean, don't you think it's time for a change? There's got to be a way out of this.
The only way out of this is by train.
No, listen.
Running no way will never make you free. Doesn't matter where you go. I guarantee, as we hold our ground, we will not be bound. Shaking the past, making our breaks, taking control, if that's what it takes. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. We can face it down right now, right here. Once you're standing on your own two feet, you will not retreat if you repeat.
I'm free! Come on, try it!
I'm free!
Let the Lord hear your voice!
A tribute to four young people who held the promise of Beaumont's brightest future.
Seven,
Maybe we don't travel well. Rusty, it is just a car ride.
But that makes it like a first date, don't you see? Oh, I should have seen the signs the whole way over. I had to do all the talking. All I said was, don't you see all my babies in a panic?
Now, don't make yourself crazy. Come on.
I'll dance with you.
Willard, what's up? I mean, you seem jumpy.
That's why I'm having a drink. Mom says I can have one drink or one cigarette. But if I ever have both, I should never come home again.
I mean, come on. You finally get out on a date with Rusty.
But wait, hold on. Is this a date? You asked me to come for a ride. Then you told Ariel to invite Rusty. It's more like I'm on a date with you.
And you look so handsome tonight.
Well, thank you. But you stuck me in the backseat with a crazy woman who won't stop moving and talking.
That's because she's excited to see you.
Well, sure, there, but problem is,
yeah?
Between you and me.
Uh-huh.
I can't do it.
It? You can't do
it? No, sir.
Well, that's okay, Willard. I mean, it's only the first date.
Right.
Even in Chicago, a lot of people don't do it on the first date.
Really?
I swear.
Oh. Well, that sure makes me feel a lot better.
Good. I'm glad. Now let's go dance.
Dance? Dance? Well, what the hell do you think I'm talking about?
Well, when you said it, I thought you meant
what?
What, it?
Oh, that? Oh, hell, any idiot can do that. I can't do this. I can't dance.
What?
Did you hear that? Your boyfriend said he can't dance.
Now, come on. Give the guy a break.
Oh, but that ain't natural.
It's like riding a bike. It's falling off a log.
It's as easy as learning to swim.
I can't swim.
My God.
Hey, fellas. What do you say to push him in the pool? Come on.
Darling,
your boyfriend has 2 left feet and you had no idea?
None. Didn't he never take you in his arms and sweep you off your feet?
Not yet.
Didn't he never whisper sweet nothings into your ear?
No.
But that's not how it is with me and Willard. No, really. Willard has lots of hidden talents. I mean, just look at him.
You were saying?
My baby, he don't talk sweet. He ain't got much to say. But he loves me, loves me, loves me. I know that he loves me anyway.
She's not here, Chuck.
Miss Moore.
Did I scare you?
No, not at all. Did you tell Ariel that?
Yes, Chuck, I told her every time you called.
Thanks. I guess she's busy and all.
She and the girls went over to Wendy Jones to study.
Really?
Yeah.
I was just there. Wendy Jones said she left hours ago with Rusty.
Oh.
Who is it by?
It's...
Oh. Mr. Cranston.
Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
Isn't it a bit late, Mr. Cranston?
Yes, sir. That's why I'm surprised she's not at home.
So am I. Good night, Mr. Cranston, and please, next time, remember, we have a front door for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Joe's. Don't bother calling, she's not there.
So, how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you?
I'm not saying anything until I hear an explanation from her.
You know, it was frightening enough when she was running off with that Chuck Cranston. Now, she's out in the middle of the night with that punk who's campaigning against me and the entire town council. How long can you keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
Oh, Rusty and
Don't me. Even bother.
We know you weren't at Wendy Joe's.
I can't believe you're checking up on me.
Sweetie, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
I am concerned for your well-being.
So then how come when I'm home, you're never interested in what I'm thinking or how I'm feeling? But the minute I walk out that door, wham, you're suddenly the concerned parent.
Shaw, she doesn't mean that.
Stop taking her side. All right, she needs to start learning to answer for herself.
I don't know what good that would do. You don't listen to me any more than you listen to her.
Ariel!
Shaw!
I've never done that before.
I know.
We're losing her by. She's becoming willful and obstinate.
Like her father.
I'm her spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I just don't understand what's happening. All right, I don't know what to do anymore.
Yes, you do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see this part of her that's trying to obey? While part of her is dying to run away, can you hear what she's trying to say? Can you find it in your soul to accept her? If she stumbles on your holy path, do you have to reprimand? Or are the ways better on the sand without using the back of your hand? Can't you remember when we were that age, pumped up with promise and wrestling with rage? Can't you remember when we were a family back when? Could we be one?
We are a family.
No! Ever since Bobby's death, you made impossible demands on Ariel.
Please, I've not confused Ariel's behavior with my son's death.
He was my son too! Shaw, it has been 21 years I've been a minister's wife. And after all that time, I still feel that you're a wonderful preacher. You can lift the congregation up so high that they have to look down to see heaven. It's the one-on-one where you need a little work.
Well, I thought at least you believed in me.
I never stopped. Does it ever cross your mind that I miss you? Is there any chance we'll find the joy that we shared at the start? Can you remember what you felt before that feeling fell apart? Can you find it in your heart? Have you lost my love somewhere far behind? Or can you find it in your
sides,
and they're not picking yours. Then, I mean, who am I kidding? I've already split the town into two halves. Maybe I just ought to forget it.
Look, little buddy. We don't mean to discourage you.
After all the posters we painted,
all the flyers we passed out, everyone at school was climbing the walls.
So hang in there. You just gotta rethink your approach. Now, Mama says that if you ever end now hold on just 1 minute. Everything I've ever learned that gets me through the worst, I've learned at my mama's knee. Now, anytime I turn around, I turn to mama first. And you be wise to memorize what mama says to me. Now,
mama ain't been wrong yet. And I live in proof.
That's kind of frightening thought, isn't it?
I wanna just wonder. Mama says don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now who can argue with that? Mama says don't hold your breath for longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at. And mama says it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Would you drive up a mountain? You can't back down.
You can't back down right now, Ren.
Now you're here to pleasure me, my mama. But these boys are here now. Come on and help me out here, fellas.
Mama says,
don't drink our coffee while lying down in bed. Oh, don't even give it a thought.
It's a mess. Mama says,
never eat anything that's bigger than your head.
Oh yes.
And mama says it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Would you drive up a mountain? You can't back down. Oh, would you drive up a mountain? You can't back down.
Now mama makes a lot of sense, you know I listen. She is clear and concise.
She's concise.
Now daddy says I love her son, but she's got heart missing.
I say, hey, it's free advice. And what do you expect at that price?
Excuse me, can I borrow your baton?
Mama says,
would you believe it? Oh, and I believe that she's right.
Mama says,
if you got doubts, well then, boy, you're not alone. Just means you're ready to fight. And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you drive a hot bargain or if you drive a
trouble tonight. I don't want to cause any more.
It's been on a
terror ever since he found out about a little field trip to the barbecue.
He ordered me not to see you. I told him I see who I like, and then he just started swinging.
Let me look at that eye.
I'm just so mad at myself. I don't know why I was with him in the first place.
You should go see a doctor.
I'm fine.
You want me to call your folks?
No, please. I just want to be left alone, okay? Let's go, guys. Come on.
You certain you don't want any company?
No. Yes?
You sure? I mean, I wouldn't take it personally if
Shh!
You...
Listen!
What?
Come on, you'll miss it! Saving. He never mentioned Bobby again.
You must miss him real bad.
I try not to think about it.
That never works. I bet you think about it all the time.
How'd you know that?
I study you.
Oh yeah? What do you see?
Someone who's smart.
Thank you.
Maybe a little angry.
Maybe a lot.
And someone who's sad. I always wondered where that came from.
Now you know.
What?
I've never felt like anyone's ever stopped to really look at me.
Oh no, I mean, you're on my mind 24 hours a day.
I thought that dreams belonged to other men. Cause each time I got close, they'd fall apart again.
I feared my heart would beat in secrecy.
I faced the nights alone. Oh, how could I have known that all my life I only needed you? Oh, almost paradise, we're knocking on heaven's door. Almost paradise, how could we ask for more? I swear that I can see forever in your eyes. Paradise.
You know, you make me forget everything that's wrong with my life.
There's a lot of things that I like to forget.
Like
this whole battle I'm causing in Beaumont. And I still don't even know what I'm gonna say to the town council.
That reminds me, you'll need this.
The Holy Bible?
I marked all the pages.
Whoa, this is great. I mean, how'd you know how to find all these passages?
You're kidding, right?
Oh, right, preacher's daughter. Thank you.
Thought that perfect love was hard to
all those dreams are saved for a rainy day.
They finally come true. I'll share them all with you. 'Cause now we hold the future in our hands. Whoa, almost paradise. We're knocking on heaven's door. Almost paradise. How could we ask for more? I swear that I can see forever in your eyes.
In your arms, salvation's not so far away.
It's getting closer, closer every day. Almost paradise, we're knocking on heaven's door. Almost paradise, how could we ask for more? I swear that I can see forever in your eyes. Paradise. Paradise.
Challenge any enterprise that, well, in my experience, fosters the use of liquor, the abuse of drugs, and most importantly, celebrates spiritual corruption. And Mr. McCormick, I think that you would come to find that most folks in this community happen to agree with me.
You got that right. Yeah!
So, if you all can convince me that there are no dangers in your ruckus party plans, well, then I may reconsider my stance. But for now, no. I just can't condone it.
I believe that a vote is in order. Well, all those in
favor... Well, hold on. Isn't there some sort of discussion?
It's outrageous if you think that!
Roger, sit down! I believe Mr. McCormick has the right to be heard.
Thank you. I think that the idea of dancing scares a lot of people.
And it shouldn't, really. Even in the oldest times, people danced for many reasons. They danced so their crops would grow, or so that their hunt would be plentiful. They danced to show community spirit, and they danced to celebrate life. That's the kind of dancing we're talking about.
Mr. McCormick, we don't need a history lesson right now.
In Psalm 149, we read, "Praise ye the Lord. Sing unto the Lord the new song. Let them praise him in the dance." And it is King David, who we read about in Samuel. And what did David do? What did David do? What did David do? David danced before the Lord with all of his might, leaping and dancing before the Lord. Leaping and dancing. And it is Ecclesiastes who assures us that there's a time to every purpose. There's a time to laugh. There's a time to weep. There's a time to mourn. And there's a time to dance. Well, this is our time. Our time to celebrate life. I mean, that's the way it was in the beginning. That's the way it always has been. And that's the way it should be now. Thank you.
Motion on the floor to repeal local ordinance 416. How does the council vote?
No.
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 The motion is defeated, and I believe this meeting is adjourned. Myself. But if I don't say something, I'm gonna bust.
I mean, what else is there to say? I lost.
Sweetie, you
never... The town council voted and I lost.
Sweetie, you never had a prayer.
Mom, that's not funny.
Ren, when you got up to the part about leaping and laughing and weeping and dancing, which I loved, don't get me wrong, I was watching the faces of the town council. I promise you, Sean Moore had those votes locked up before he even walked in here tonight.
Are you saying you told them how to vote?
You can still sound shocked. I love that about you.
But he's a man of God.
He's a man. And you were railroaded.
Damn. That pisses me off.
Good. Now listen, Reverend Moore said he would reconsider only if someone convinced him there was no danger in your ruckus party plans.
Ruckus party plans? I mean, do you believe these people? What?
Make him reconsider.
Me?
You.
And him.
Yup.
When?
Now.
But...
Ren.
Mom.
Stop. Until you do, you'll never make peace with that man. Or this town.
Reverend Moore is a very smart man.
So are you.
He's stubborn.
And you're not? Look, I'd love to be there to watch, but I've got to get home and hose down your aunt and uncle.
I love you, Mom.
You have no choice.
Reverend Moore, Mr. McCormick, it's late.
Really?
I'm wide awake. All right. I have a question. Am I going to wait until morning?
Just one question. Before tonight's meeting, did you tell the council how to vote?
Oh,
Well, I mean, well, we briefly spoke of the issue, of course, and then okay, we went over.
Did you tell them how to vote?
Ren, I think that this is much more than a question of dance.
Did you?
Reverend Moore,
I understand what this town has been through.
No, I don't think you do. All right, because if you did, you would not have provoked all your classmates to reopen the wounds we have already healed. You have done nothing.
Those wounds are not healed. If they were, I wouldn't be glared at in the street. My mother would not be sneered at in the market. My uncle's business would not be boycotted, and you wouldn't be rigging the vote to the town council.
I thought it was about time to put an end to this nonsense.
Nonsense? All I ask is, who's up for a little dancing? And all people here can think about is four kids and what happened.
Mr. McKinnick!
And I know your son was one of them. And I'm sorry, I truly am. But honoring their memory by shutting out the rest of the world isn't worth it.
Oh, and I suppose that you have all the answers?
No,
and
I don't.
You're going to set me straight?
I didn't say
how can you presume to know what I have been through when you don't have a clue? Good night, Mr. McCormick.
Please, Reverend, I...
Mr. McCormick! I would like to be alone.
Sir, you already are. We both are. You and me, we both lost somebody very close to us. And even though people say they understand how that feels, they don't really. I bet you stop 100 times a day and wonder why. I do. I wonder why my dad left me. Was it something I did? Something I didn't do? Maybe I could do something to bring him back. Maybe I could change his mind, but I can't. But I don't have to tell you how that feels. You already know.
I do.
So I know I came to town angry and frustrated, and it felt really good to kick up a fuss, but in doing so, I hurt a lot of people. And I'm sorry, really, I truly am. But I just want to put all this in the past behind us, and I can't stand still.
So I've noticed.
Well, I know you've got a big decision to make in the morning, Reverend, and I'll leave you to that, but thank you for listening. Ren, I'm sorry your father will never get to know you. Thanks.
Daddy?
Oh, well, I didn't hear you come down.
I heard voices.
That was your friend, Ren. He sure asks a lot of questions.
What did you tell him?
Well, for once, I have very little to say. I think I'm running out of answers.
Daddy, I know it's hard for you, and I know I don't make it any easier, but I'm not sure if I believe in everything you believe in, but I believe in you. Get some sleep. You have a sermon in the morning.
I can figure out what to say.
You will.
When souls come to me for protection, I guide them whatever the cost. But while I've been given direction, maybe it's me who got lost. Heaven help me find my way now. Open up my
stand before you all this morning with a very troubled heart. You see, my friends, as your minister, I should be helping you all to find the joy in your lives. But last night, I realized I have not been doing that. After all, we all remember that terrible night 5 years ago, where the lives of 4 young people were lost. Everyone in this community lost someone that night. A child, a neighbor, a friend. I, we lost our son. And Ariel lost her brother. And now somehow I got it through my head that my loss was the greatest, and that my pain was the deepest. And last night, someone much younger than I, made me realize how tightly I've been holding on to that memory. A memory that has weighed me down as surely as a great stone. And in that moment, I did something I have not done in a very, very long time. I laid down my burden. It was a terrifying moment, and it was exhilarating. And this morning, I offered each and every one of you that same opportunity. The senior class of Beaumont High has asked me permission to throw a dance. And Bren, I think that might be a great idea. Please join me in asking our Lord to guide and protect our children.
So we don't end up smelling like the dogs.
Uh-huh.
Daddy's suit kind of fits. I can roll the pain legs with duct tape.
I love where this is going.
And, Mom could whip up one of those. Croissant?
Corsage.
One of them.
You're painting a picture for me, aren't you? I see a rusty truck that smells bad. You in a taped up suit. And me! Wearing a corsage man in a god knows what.
What do you think?
Is there a dance in there someplace?
Yes, ma'am. You want?
Oh, Willard! I'd love to!
So don't even think about it.
You did a good thing this morning.
I'm still not entirely sure it was the right thing to do.
I think it comes close. I miss you. I miss us.
I hope you never doubt that I love you. If that's hard to figure out sometimes, well then I apologize. But you are dearer to my life than you could ever realize. If I try and make amends, can you teach me how to start? Can you find it in your heart? Jeff.
We're almost dancing.
Please, go on.